嗨，大家好，我是林昀晴医师。
在上一集牙齿美白的影片中，我们谈到了莫彩希是做了哪五件事情让她可以拥有一口白牙。这五件事中不包括有做牙齿美白。那其实这是因为莫彩希她是天生丽质，很少人的牙齿的齿色是本来就像她这么白的。那如果说你的牙齿齿色是像我一样，那可能你就需要靠一些牙齿美白来让你的牙齿看起来更亮丽。那集影片中我也解释了为什么我还是没有选择做牙齿美白，这主要是因为我的肤色其实是比较黄的，那再加上我平常大部分的时候其实没有化妆，所以我的肤色跟我的齿色搭配起来其实看起来还是很自然的。可是如果说像我在拍照的时候我就会化妆，那因为牙齿没有办法化妆，所以只好靠后置的修图来让我的齿色变白。所以若是肤色比较白的人，或者是说有工作需求常常需要拍照录影的人，我觉得做牙齿美白没有什么不好的。所以我这一集的重点呢会放在居家美白的美白效果，这主要是因为我觉得居家美白是最省钱也最温和的美白方式。
居家美白其实又分成两种形式，一种形式就是你的美白药剂取得方式是自己在外面的开价的彩妆买到的美白药剂，包括一些美白笔、美白贴片这些产品。那第二种居家美白的方式是你到牙医诊所去，那你取得的美白药剂呢是由诊所的医师的处方来给你的。借由诊所的方式取得的美白药剂的话，它的美白药剂浓度是可以比较高的，所以这类的居家美白的效果就会比你在外面开价彩妆买到的美白药剂的浓度的效果还要好。那老实说呢，即使是你自己买一些美白产品，完全没有经过医生或是牙医诊所开处方给你，只要你买到的美白药剂浓度是足够的，你使用的方式是正确的话，还是会有美白效果的。举个例子，比如说像是在台湾，你可以在外面屈臣氏买到的美白贴，你就只能买到温和型的，那它的美白药剂浓度只有 6%。 可是如果说你是在亚马逊网站上，或者是说你在香港的屈臣氏你就可以买到 Professional Effect 的包装，那这种包装它的那个药剂浓度有到 10%， 美白效果呢相对就会比只有 6% 的温和型还要更好。
The whitening product I used was Crest 3D White Strips. Super easy to use. I could wear it when I was working, when I was exercising, when I was shopping. Very, very convenient, undetectable. And you put a strip on the top teeth, on the bottom teeth, for 1 hour a day for 20 days. I think it definitely made my teeth brighter, probably whiter, and I would recommend it.
那如果想要得到更好效果的牙齿美白的话，可能需要使用牙托式的美白方式。
Notice that you only put a relatively small amount of gel in each tooth. Insert the trays over your teeth.And be sure to push the tray all the way over the teeth. The thick gel has pushed the sides of the tray away from the teeth a little. It is very important that you very gently push the tray back against the teeth until the edges of the tray contact the teeth next to the gum line. You should see just a little excess gel has squeezed out of the edge of the tray as the trays are gently pushed back against the teeth.If you see an excessive amount of gel, the trays have been overfilled. On the other hand, if you see no gel has squeezed out, place more gel the following night. Wipe the slight excess gel off with a paper towel or just your finger.
台湾很多牙医诊所使用的美白药剂是 Opalescence 这家厂商出品的美白药剂，那这种美白药剂台湾的病人并没有办法自行在一些开价的彩妆店取得，必须要由牙医诊所的医师来给。当然如果说你是在国外没有办法取得这些美白药剂的话，你可以自己在家里做牙托式的牙齿美白。
I did the peroxide solution by Opalescence. It was 20% peroxide and you put that into a tray and then you put that on your teeth upper and lower. And then I also used the Opalescence whitening toothpaste. And I ended up liking it. It tasted okay. It wasn't great. I definitely felt like it whitened my teeth. My teeth were so much brighter after the first week when I used it. Forgot to use it one night. I used it every other night, but at night I went from maybe an hour. Some nights I used it maybe 3 hours. One of the issues that I ran into it was when I did the mouth guard, you would dip it in hot water and then it would kind of melt and then you could mold it to your teeth. And I actually molded it improperly and it caused a lot of pain and sensitivity at the bottom of my lower gum. So just read the instructions before you do it because I actually didn't. So it wasn't exactly a pleasant thing to put in every night, but I definitely felt like it whitened my teeth a lot.
除了碍于法规的规定，你要能够取得比较高浓度的美白药剂之外，牙托式的牙齿美白方式如果靠自己做的话，必须要自己来做这一副美白牙托，是有一点点小技巧的，大家可能需要很仔细的看那个产品的介绍，看要怎么做能够更服帖你的牙齿。但是如果到牙医诊所做的话，是由牙医诊所来进行印模，然后送到技工室直接做一个非常符合你牙齿的牙托，它戴的时候可能会更舒服。至于美白牙膏和美白笔，可能受限于美白药剂的浓度比较低，还有就是停留在牙齿上面的时间比较短，所以它的美白效果就没有前面两个产品那么好。
I did the Super Smile Teeth Whitening Kit. It was not difficult, but it was kind of time consuming. You have to use two different toothpastes. One is an accelerator, one is almost like an abrasive kind of toothpaste. You mix those together on the toothbrush and use that. Then you have to use a rinse, which tasted terrible. It also came with a little paint on whitening that you could take with you on the go. I don't know that I noticed a really big difference between the before and the after. I have used other products that I feel were much more effective than this. I don't know that I would recommend the whole Super Smile kit if you were going to try it. I would get just the toothpaste and the accelerator that you can buy separately without having to get the whole kit.
最后呢，我想要再来谈一下牙齿美白的三个方法：居家美白、冷光美白，还有做美白贴片。如果说你想要做牙齿美白的话呢，我个人建议的顺序，第一个还是考虑居家美白，因为一来它美白的药剂浓度比较低，所以相对的美白后一些牙齿敏感的问题会比较少，而且我觉得这样子安全性相对也比较高。那第二个冷光美白就是第二个考虑的选项，也就是当你觉得你想要在很短的时间内比较快速的变白，或者是说像我之前在影片中讲的，如果说你在隔两三天就要结婚的话，那你如果说只做居家美白的话，这个时间会来不及，那你可能就要考虑做冷光美白，比较快速的方式来达到一个牙齿美白的效果。那第三个就是做磁贴片的方式，这个方式呢，我还是要再强调，就是你需要磨耗一点点你牙齿的齿质，所以呢，我觉得它是最后一个选项，除非你有以下的几个问题，第一个就是你对牙齿的对称性的要求非常的高，还有你想要有一个很漂亮的微笑曲线，你对牙齿细节的要求非常的高的话，你可以考虑做磁贴片，同时达到这几个效果。那第二个就是如果说你牙齿本身的形状非常的小颗，相对的你做磁贴片，你所要磨耗的齿质量也会比较少，尤其是在锥状侧门牙的一些情况下呢，你可以考虑做磁贴片。那第三个就是如果说你是很严重四环霉素染色的话，那这种情况下呢，可能做磁贴片也是一个可以达到牙齿美白一劳永逸效果的一个方式。好了，那我今天的内容就到这里了。如果说喜欢我的影片的话，可以在底下订阅、留言、按赞、分享，还有记得要开启小铃铛哦。那我们就下次再见了，拜拜。